Hello guys and welcome back. And today I'm going to talk about the person that in a way started all for me, because he's the person that I first started to watch on YouTube long time ago. And in a way he's the person that made me the man that I am today. And that person is this guy, Elliott Hulse. Elliott is the father of four kids, three girls and one boy. He was a football player, he was a strongman, and right now he owns a chain of strength gyms called Strength Camp. He is a very spiritual man. On his YouTube channel, you're going to find there a lot of videos about workouts, about energy, about religion, about life advice. And I will leave on the description box all the links to his channels. I'm going to start telling you about the things that I learned from Elliott, and I will start with number one: move your body. Moving your body, it's very important for your well-being, not just for the exterior, because you start lifting weights or you do a sport and you start to look better, you feel better, but also for the interior, because a way for you to get over depression is actually to start moving, to do more exercise, because that's how you get more energetic. That's how you get from your mind into your body. Focus. Number two. Being focused is very important with everything that you do. You need to be focused at the micro level, because here you are talking about being focused on the task at hand and not getting distracted by what is happening around you, not getting distracted by your phone, by the media, by your friends. You need to get focused at the macro level. That means that you need to stay focused when you are staying on your purpose. And when you are hitting a setback or something is not going the way you want or the way that you like, and that is going to happen, you need to stay focused. You need to put your blinders on like a horse and stay on your purpose. Having a purpose, number three. Having a purpose is like you eating. You can live for a while without it, but in the end, if you are not going to do it, you are going to die a miserable person. I don't know if that's the best metaphor, but that's the one that I got. I hope that you get the idea. It's crucial for you to have a purpose in life. Number four, do what you fear. Fear, I think, is the biggest thing that keeps us from living a happier life. It can be fear of judgment, it can be fear of failure, fear of heights, fear of success. Any one of that can keep you from living a better and happier life. The only thing that you can do to get past that fear is to do it, to confront it. Fear is like an anchor that keeps a ship in harbor. If you cut that rope attached to that anchor, or if you release that anchor, what will happen? The ship can go wherever she wants to go. I have a fear of heights, and every time I have the opportunity to conquer that fear, I do it. Don't get me wrong. Every time I do it, my body starts shivering, my breathing is shallow, every fiber in my body says no, 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 stop, stop, don't do it. But I still do it. And guess what happens? The next time I can go higher and higher and higher. Number five, become the strongest version of yourself. Below Elliott photo, I have this quote. It's not about what you get, it's about what you become. This is very important, especially when you are going through a rough period in your life. Because in that moment, you are not seeing the things in perspective. You are not seeing the bigger picture. Because you are there, you are suffering. Maybe it's that girl or that boy that you loved and she or he left you. Or maybe it's the fact that you just lost your job and you have a big debt to pay and the banks is calling you. Give me the money, give me the money. Maybe that pain is the thing that you need in order for you to get to the next level and to get out of your comfort zone. Maybe that pain is the thing that you need in order for you to get that desperate that you can take the risk. Take me for example. A few years ago, I started dating this girl. And this girl, in my opinion, at that time was the perfect woman. She was dead gorgeous, sexy body, smart, and we started dating. And after that, after a few weeks, guess what happened? She dumped me. Can imagine that I was sad. And that pain made me want to know more about how I can not only attract a woman and also to keep her beside me. And with time, I realized that with her, I acted like a little bitch. Due to that pain, now I'm able to not be needy around women. I'm able to pursue my goal. I'm able to go after the things that I want. So if the girl that I'm talking about is watching this video, thank you. Number six, hustle. I told you that Elliott has a chain of strength gyms called Strength Camp. That wasn't always the case. Strength Camp actually started in the back of his van with which he will go to parks, and there he would train his clients. Number seven, don't fear failure. This is a powerful one, especially today when in this society everybody is programming us and is telling us not to fail, that failure is bad. When in fact, sometimes you failing is the best thing that can happen to you. Failure is painful. Yes, it's not pleasant. But failure sometimes is the thing that is going to prepare you to reach the next level. It will teach you more than it can any success can teach you. It will humble you. If you become too self-centered, and it's the thing that sometimes you need in order for you to be able to get to the next level and to be able to face the next thing. Number eight, believe in yourself. A lot of people are afraid to take a chance on their ideas, are afraid to believe in themselves. Either because they are afraid of the unknown, or they are afraid of the other people's judgment. Believing in yourself is the hardest thing sometimes to do. But once you start doing it, everything in your life will change. You are going to get more confident. You are going to have more opportunities. You are going to start to walk on the path of your true self. Number nine. Breathe into your balls. This sounds a little bit odd, but it's not. Breathing into your balls means that you start breathing on a deeper level. It means that you don't breathe from your chest. It's not a shallow breathing, but it's a deeper one. It's one from the stomach. What that will do, it's going to calm you. Today we are living in a very head-dominated society. We live in a very excited world. And that breathing deeply, breathing into your balls, will help you ground you, will help you go from your head and into your body. That's why a lot of people are smoking. When you are smoking, you are breathing deeper. That's why when a person is stressed and he is a smoker, he's going to most likely say, I need to take a cigarette. That's why when you have a panic attack, the doctor says to breathe deeper. Number 10, help others. It is said that when you are taking the action of helping others, you are losing yourself. because every time you are thinking about others, you are stop thinking about yourself. You are shifting from a place of lack onto a place of abundance, and that will help you elevate your state. Helping others, in fact, is the best way for you to help yourself, because helping others is going to help you see that even if right now you are in a tough place, in a tough spot, it always can be worse. That's it, guys. 10 things that I learned from Elliott. I hope that you enjoyed this video. I hope that you go to his channels, which the links are going to be in the description, and you start listening to what he is saying. I am certain that in one of his videos you are going to find something that is going to resonate with you and is going to help you to become the better version of yourself. And until next time, guys, I wish you all the best. Like the video if you enjoyed the video. Subscribe to the channel for more content like this, and comment in the box below what thing from the 10 things that I talk about, Elliott, did you enjoy the most and you are going to apply into your life. And until next time, don't forget, you're amazing.